Hello guys, welcome to the next video on Linux command line tutorial for beginners. In this video we will see how we can use file permissions in Linux, and especially we are going to talk about symbolic permissions in Linux. So let's get started. First of all, what I'm going to do is I will just change the directory to the desktop, and you can see here I have a file which has a name file itself, right? So what I want to do is I want to list the long listing of this file. So I will just do ls minus l and press enter. And maybe in the previous video also I have touched this topic, that these thing here is the permission for the file. Now the first dash on the left hand side, you can see dash or minus, whatever you call it, is the type of file. For example, if it's a normal dash, it means it's a normal file. If it would be a D, then it would be a directory. Or if it would be a character special file, then it would be a C. Or if it would be B, then it would be a binary special file, right? Now the next three group, next three dash group or whatever, next three element you can say here, is for the owner of the file, right? And then next three is for the group of the file. So group contains these rights, and the last three is for the permission, is the permission for everybody else, right? Now the next you can see here is one, and one stands for the symbolic links of the file. So right now we have only one link, right? Now the next is this name, which is for the owner of the file. So the name of the owner of the file is this one, right? Next is the name of the group of the file. So this is for the group. Now next is this one, and this is for the size of the file. So right now our file size is 22, and then next is the date on which it's created, and then the file name, right? So these are the permissions. So basically we are interested in this area, which is the user, group and other permissions, and the name of the user and the group, right? So let's try to change the permission of this file. So there is a utility called chmod, which stands for change mod, to change the permission of the file. So for example, I want to provide the permission to the user also. But first of all, what kind of permission we have? So for this file, for example, we have three main kind of permission. One is read, other is write, and third one is executable, right? So R stands for read, W stands for write, and X stands for executable. So read, write, executable permission for a file, okay? So for example, what I want to do is I want to change the permission of others to execute this file. So I want to allow the other persons to execute this file, for example, right? So what I can do is I will just use chmod, which is the utility to change the permission of the file, and then I can give the first of all name of others. So for example, O stands for others here, and then plus or minus. Plus is for adding the permission, and minus is for subtracting the permission, and then the permission itself. So I want to grant the executable permission to the other user. So O stands for other here, plus is for adding the permission, and X, for example, is the permission, so executable permission, right? And then the name of the file itself, so file, right? And I will press enter here. So permission is changed. And once again, when we do ls minus l, you can see here, earlier the others doesn't have the executable permission, but now the others have executable permissions, right? Next, what we can do here is, once again, we can change the permission of others to write also. So we can do W here and then press enter, and once again we will do the long listing, and you can see the others can write and execute, and the read permission they already had, so they can now read, write and executable. Now it's not necessary that you want to do this for in the normal circumstances, but this is just for the example we want to, so I want to show you, right? So for example, now I want to change the permission of the group, and the group already have the permission read and write, right? So I want to change it to read, write, executable. So for the group, once again, we will use chmod, and then for group G, and then plus X. So we will change the permission of the group and the name of the file, and just press enter, and then long listing once again, and you can see now the group can also read, write and execute. Now for example, once again I want to reduce the permission of the group once again. So right now group can read, write and execute, and I want to make it just to read, so just allow the group to only read the file. So once again chmod, and as I told you, G is for group and minus is for reducing the permission, right? So we want to remove, for example, write and executable, right? And then the name of the file, and once again when I press enter, and once again when I do long listing, now you can see group can only read, because we have subtracted the permission of the group to write and execute using this notation. Okay, now for example, I want to give the permission to everybody. So for example, I want to give the user of this file or owner of this file to read, write and execute, and also I want to give the group of this file to read, write and execute. So what I can do is, here one more notation I can use, which is for example chmod, and then the user is for the user, and for example I want to also change the group. So you can change the permission for multiple group or user. For example, you want to change it for user also and for the group also, so you can use this combination also, right? And you can also use equal to, so which is for granting the permission also. So this notation is also used to changing the permission, and I want to make it read, write and execute. So I will just do read, write, execute, RWX for read, write, execute. Okay, so this will change the permission of user or owner of this file and the group of this file to read, write and execute, and the name of the file, don't forget, right? And then press enter, and once again we will do the long listing, and now we can see everybody have read, write and execute permissions, right? Now for example, I want to remove the permission or change the permission to everybody, right? So for example, I want to remove the permission for the user and the group and the others, so that they cannot even read, write or execute, right? So once again I will do chmod, and what you can do is, you can do user, group and the other, you can do the notation something like this, and then you can for example do something like minus read, write and execute, something like this, okay? And this will remove the permission, or otherwise you can just do you can just use A for all, and then you can do minus and then do read, write and execute, right? So A stands for all, so it stands for user, or owner, group, and others. So you are basically want to subtract all the permission from all the users, and you can press enter. Before that, we need to give the name of the file, press enter, and then use long listing. And now we can see nobody has the permission to change or read, write, or execute this file, right? Now, for example, I want to give everybody their permission back. So I want to give the same status I have in the starting. So I want to give the owner of this file read and write, group also read and write, and the others just the read permission. So what I can do is I can do chmod, and for the user I want to add once again the permission read and write, okay, and then you can use the comma to give the others the permission, for example group, and once again we want to give the permission to the group read and write. Or you can do this thing, something like read and write using equals, both are the same commands. And then for the others we want to just give the read permission, something like this, and the name of the file, okay? So use comma in order to separate the permission, or if you want to change the multiple permission of the multiple users, right? And press enter, and it gives some problem. Let's see what's the problem is. Yeah, so the problem is chmod is not spelled correctly, so I must correct it. So I will remove this A, and now the command is normal, right? So I will press enter, and now once again I will do the long listing, and now once again we have the normal permission of the file. So for owner we have read write, group we have read write, and for other we have read permission. So this is how you can change the permission of a file using symbolic notation. So this R, W, or X is called a symbolic notation, right? So this is how you can change the permission. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and bye for now.